Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Welcome everyone. I am happy to come on live in this 24-hour prayer. May God bless everyone. Today Holy Spirit will touch your hearts. I am going to pray for some subjects given to me. It is about, hallelujah, there are four subjects given to me about the one is miracles to happen in the ministry, the second death for deliverance, third God destroy the enemies of his people, and also the fourth one, God to speak to his people. Amen. Hallelujah. So I welcome everyone, those who are watching this live video. I welcome all the viewers. I thank God in the name of Jesus for giving me an opportunity to come on live. Also, I thank Apostle Jacqueline Smith for inviting me to this 24-hour prayer. So, we all pray. There are some subjects. We all pray for these subjects. So, today, God will touch your hearts, I believe. So, there will be another prayer warrior. Or at the same time, when I am ministering in this live video, there is another number. You can call in that number. And there will be a prayer warrior attending, and it is 24 hours, it is continuously ministering and praying. So today God will speak, God will do wonders. God is going to extend your boundaries, you are going to see the miracles. It depends upon your faith, hallelujah. So open your heart, give everything to Jesus, and Jesus will touch you. Do not your eyes, your brain, everything be limited, but open your heart and God will touch you, hallelujah. So the first one is to pray about the miracles, hallelujah. So, the greatest miracle we have seen is that we have got the Son of God, Jesus. So, the greatest miracle is to get Jesus. There are many people in this earth, but only few of us are able to receive Jesus Christ as Savior. Nobody else doesn't even, they are not interested to hear the Gospels. But God has given us the grace to hear the Gospel, and we have been saved, we have taken baptism, we have received Holy Spirit. This is the greatest miracle a person can achieve in this in his lifetime. Hallelujah. So I welcome everyone, Sister Charlotte Downs, I welcome everyone. So today I'm going to pray for miracles to happen in our ministry. Wherever we go, we should see miracles. Every day we should see miracles. Hallelujah. Our God is a God of miracle. So, if you believe, you will see miracles. Hallelujah. God is going to extend the boundary of those who believe, because God is a God of miracle. When the Israelites were in front of the Red Sea, they cannot move forward. They cannot even go back. But what happened? Our God is a God of miracle. So, He divided the Red Sea. Today, you will see a miracle like that. Your obstacles, that your big mountains that stand before you, that you cannot move, God will make a wind to pass, and God will move all the mountains that stand before you, and you will see brother Victor Sam, you will see a miracle. God's hand is upon you. In these hours you will see a miracle. Your family will see a miracle, because our God is a great God. Hallelujah. So I am going to pray for this first subject which has been given to me. It is about to pray for the miracles to happen in our ministry, in our home, in our life, in our church, wherever we go, to see the miracles. Whatever we do, it should be a miracle. Hallelujah. So let us close our eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for this fine day you have given. Lord, I pray for this 24-hour prayer group. I pray for Apostle Jacqueline. I pray for all the members. I pray for all the admin, all those who are watching. I pray, I submit everyone and all the members, every family member, I submit. Let everyone see a miracle. At this hour, we are waiting for a miracle, Lord. Let fire from God be released from heaven and touch each and every one of us. Let us see the Red Sea divided. Let us see the Red Sea before us be divided. Let us see the Jericho wall smashed down. Let us see a miracle. Hallelujah. Let us see a miracle by your hand, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let everyone who ministers in this group, let their church, let their ministry see a miracle in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So, our God is a great God. It depends upon some people, when they come to church, they don't believe in miracles. If only you believe in miracles, if only you expect a miracle, in your life you can see miracles. Some people say, why always talking about miracles? No, our God is a God of miracles. From Genesis to Revelation, we can see God's hand. It was all miracle, not anything done by human wisdom. It was everything by the wisdom of God. It was miracle. Hallelujah. So in these days, in these hours, you will see, you will expect a great miracle. You will see a great miracle. Hallelujah. I see heaven open, and those who are watching this live video, whatever mountains that stand before you, whatever obstacles there are before you, that is an entrance for your deliverance. I sense that God is going to do a miracle and pushing away all the mountains. Jesus has said that if you have faith like that of a mustard seed, you can even move away the mountains. So great miracles you will see. It depends upon your faith. It depends upon how you believe. Hallelujah. So Mark 10:27, it says everything is possible for God. So whatever that is impossible today at this time when I am ministering here, whatever that is impossible in your life, maybe it is a financial deliverance, maybe it is a marriage issue, maybe it is some other family problem, but you have been praying for many years, you have been praying for many weeks, but still this time not seen a deliverance. But I pray, I prophesy in the name of Jesus that you will see a miracle in this hour. You will see a miracle like the Elijah fed by the raven, like that miracles, great miracles. Hallelujah. So you will see miracles. Hallelujah. You will see great, great miracles for everything. It is possible for God. Even it is impossible for men, everything is possible for God. So, Brother Victor Sam, you will see a miracle. Your family is near the edge of a miracle. Your family is going to see a miracle. I see angels coming to and fro, coming to your house, and you are expecting a great miracle. You are going to see great miracle in your family, in your life. Hallelujah. The second subject that is given to me is to pray about, hallelujah, it is about deliverance. How many of you want deliverance? God told Joshua told the Israelites that tomorrow I am going to do a miracle. So God wanted to deliver the people. God wanted to do a miracle among the Israelites. So God told the Israelites, God told to Joshua the leader to tell the Israelites that tomorrow God is going to do a miracle. Tomorrow I am going to do a miracle, so everyone get purified. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So one condition is that if you want a deliverance in your life, you need a purity in your life. Without purification you cannot see deliverance. Hallelujah. Without purification, there is no need of expecting. You cannot expect a miracle, because if you want a miracle, if you want a deliverance, the first thing what you want is purity in your life. Throughout your life, if you want the hand of God to come upon you, you need purity. Your mind, your eyes, your heart, your body, everything. Your soul, everything should be purified. That's why God told Joshua to tell the Israelites that tomorrow I am going to do a miracle, so everyone get purified. the book of Hebrews 12:14 says that without purification no one can see God. So is anybody watching this live video expecting a miracle? Hallelujah. Something is leaking, something is going out without your knowledge. But Holy Spirit is saying that it will be restored, everything will come in the same position, and people will be against you, but you be calm, quiet, and you will be there, you will be settling in the same place where you are. You need not to go anywhere. Hallelujah. This word is for Audrey Brown sister. Holy Spirit is saying that you need not to go anywhere. Wherever you are, you'll be there, and God's hand will come upon you, and God is confirming you to you are going to see a miracle in this hour. You are going to see the deliverance. Hallelujah. So today I'm going to pray for you about this deliverance. Some people come into the church but they are not seeing any deliverance. They see other people get delivered. Some people will see other people get delivered, but they are not getting any deliverance. It is like the Israelites. They were numerous. They were in a large number, but only few were able to. Others only saw the rest getting delivered. Hallelujah. It should not happen to us. So you must find out why that deliverance is delayed. Why the deliverance is not happening in your life. Hallelujah. So you have to take heed what the Bible says. You must meditate the word of God and what the Lord says. Without holiness, without purification, you cannot see any deliverance. Because even God can deliver you, even if you are in the wilderness, God can feed you, God can lead you, God can give you everything. Our God is a great God. Wherever you are, His hand is not shortened, His hand is right now coming upon you, and you are going to see the deliverance. So in the 1 Peter 5:6 it says, humble yourselves, humble yourselves. Hallelujah. Then God will lift you up at the right time. So in 1 Peter 5:6, you must understand that. Humble yourself. So if you want a deliverance, every time you must pray to God. Your prayer must be like this. Lord, I fear you. I humble myself. Lord, I want to obey the word of God. Give me grace to obey the word of God. Lord, I humble myself. So the Bible says, 1 Peter 5:6, it says, humble yourselves and God will lift you up at His time, not at your time. So kneel down and pray and see the deliverance. At this time, you are going to see a great miracle in your life. It is going to happen. Things are going systematically. Things are going systematically. What you have to do is you have to just stand on the way and just simply praise, and you will see the hand of God coming upon you. Big mountains that is in front of you are moving. Sister Charles Downs, big mountains are moving. I see like that. Hallelujah. You are going to get the key of the house, and you will be there without no doubt. You will be there. Holy Spirit is saying. So in these days you will see the miracle. So hallelujah. I'm going to pray for those who want a deliverance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord my Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone, those who are watching, everyone who needs a deliverance. Yes, do not be afraid. Stay where you are. Do not be afraid. It is confirming. The word is confirming. Do not be afraid. Stay where you are and you will see the miracle. You need not to run away. The enemy will run away. So you just be where you are and God will lift you up. Humble yourself before the Lord and Lord will lift you up. Lord, I pray for everyone. Those who are watching this live video, give them a deliverance. Today itself, at this hour, let your hand come upon it, deliver them, let the fire of God come.
come from heaven right now. Let right now the fire of God be released in the name of Jesus, breaking the chains and delivering everyone in the name of Jesus. I sense the fire of God. I sense the presence of God. I feel hot in my body. God is pouring His Spirit upon everyone, breaking the chains, all the curses in the name of Jesus. Let everyone be freed in the name of Jesus. His hand is not Gaza. It is penetrating into yours. Yes, you cannot see, but you are going to see. You cannot feel, but you are going to feel. God is protecting you. God is giving you advance for everything, to purchase the land. God is giving you the money, so need not to be afraid. Hallelujah. So in these days, God is going to happen. Lord is telling a word to you, Apostle Jacqueline Smith. You have been praying for a land, you have been praying for a house. Now Holy Spirit is saying it is on the way. It is on the way to the ruined place. Ruined place from the city to the village. In between I see, near the park I see the plot for you. Hallelujah. I see it, from city to the old village, on the way I see near the park the plot for you. Hallelujah. You pray for that. God will do miracle. God will do miracle. Hallelujah. God will provide everything for you. So the third one is to pray for, hallelujah, God to destroy the enemies of His people. Hallelujah. So our God is a great God. He will fight for you. You need only to be silent. Just be quiet. The battle is God's. You just praise where you are. You need not to do anything. You only need to praise God, and God will fight the battle for you. Hallelujah. So I'm going to pray for you, everyone. How many of you are saying that I have an enemy? If you ask Jesus will say that I have only Satan as the enemy. I have no enemy in this world. So we have to find who is behind that human being. It is the devil. So we have to fight against the dark forces. We have to fight against the evil forces, not the what we see with our eyes. Not so we should not feel any hatred towards any of our enemies that we see with our eyes, but we have to open our inner eyes and see who is the real enemy. Who is the real enemy? Hallelujah. Rasharama. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So I am praying for everyone. Lord, right now, in the name of Jesus, I sense. God told Joshua, no one will stand in your life, never before you. No one will stand against you. That was a promise given to Joshua. So today, how many of you receive, how many of you accept this? How many of you receive this word? That is, no one will stand against you in your life. Hallelujah. Be bold. Be courageous. Jesus is with you. Wherever you go, you will see the enemy. Nobody will. You will see the enemy scattered. You will see the enemy running. They will come in one direction, but they will go in seven directions. You will never see any enemy in your life, because the promise given to Joshua is now to us also, those who believe. Hallelujah. Those who have Holy Spirit. So maybe your enemy is financial problem. Maybe your enemy is cancer. Maybe your enemy is some other dreadful diseases. Maybe your enemy is family problem. Maybe it is something that is keeping you away from moving forward. Something is stagnant. Maybe you have many, many enemies. But today, you will never see the Egyptians. God told the Israelites, You will never see the Egyptians. You will never see the enemy. How many of you say amen? You will financial breakthrough. Financial breakthrough, Apostle Jacqueline Smith. Hallelujah. Ministry enlargement and more courage and ability God giving to you. Rectify yourself and keep distance with those who are not according to God's will. Holy Spirit is saying, Hallelujah. So Lord, I pray for everyone. Let the power of God be released. Let angels with swords be released from heaven to protect every one of God's children from all the enemies in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 It will be different. But if you wait, you will see the miracle. Gaza, Holy Spirit is saying, the thing you have been imagining, it will be different. I do not know what your project is, but it is a different project. Yes, Gaza, you will see that God is the provider, and I see a railway line. It means there is a way you can move forward. Do not be doubtful, don't be with a double mind. You can move forward. The enemy might come, but God will overcome your enemy, and he will fight for you. And I see settlement. I see settlement in your life. I see everything coming favorable in your life. I do not know whether you are working in a hospital. I see something like that, but God is taking care of you. God is protecting you. God's angels are with you. So the fourth one, that is given to pray for everyone is to God to speak to his people. Is God speaking to you? Can you hear the voice of God? Open your ears and listen to God's voice. If you are in the midst of a heavy traffic, you cannot see the bus you are waiting for because it is a heavy traffic, many vehicles are going. But if you are in a village and there is no other traffic, no other vehicle, and you are waiting for your bus, you can hear that bus coming even 2 or 3 kilometers away because there is no other obstacle, no hindrance. It is God's voice is like God is always knocking at your heart. It is God is God wants to have fellowship with you. He wants to speak to you. So open your ears. You will hear God speaking right now. More power, more energy is needed for you. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit is saying, don't be highly speed. Be in speed with the Holy Spirit and God will take you. You are somewhat Walter Williams. I see an appointment is coming in your life. Appointment, something God is going to give birth to something, some grace, more prophetic anointing in you. You are going to minister to many. You are going to travel to many. Walter Williams, brother, you are going to see many miracles. So I'm going to pray. Samuel, God called Samuel, but he was not able to recognize. So today, make yourself clean. So God has called you to worship him, to hear his voice, to obey what he says. One of the way which God speaks to you is through Bible. Hallelujah. So God is speaking to you through Bible, through the Bible verses, through the biblical verses God is speaking to you. Hallelujah. If you meditate the biblical verse, you will, the next step is God will speak to you directly. And some people want to hear the voice of God. First meditate the word of God. Then have a fellowship with God and God will speak to you. Hallelujah. So today I'm going to pray for you. So I believe that if you have faith, your inner eyes are going to be opened. Your inner man is going to be strengthened, and you are going to hear the voice of God. Hallelujah. Before you speak, you can hear what Lord is saying. In the book of John, we can see that Jesus saying that when I go, I will send the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will hear from God and will tell to you. It is like that. Hallelujah. Sister Polia Winlock, Holy Spirit is saying, be with your friend. Be with your friend, and the friend will help you. So I see a friend is there with you to help you. Lord is saying, be with you. Hallelujah. So I'm going to pray for everyone. God to speak to his people right now in the name of Jesus. Open their ears, open their eyes, open their heart. Let their brain be touched right now to hear the voice. Right now, Lord, speak. Let them hear the audible voice, like as you spoke to Moses face to face, in the name of Jesus. Right now, right now, let your hand come upon everyone. I pray for everyone, those who are in this group. Lord, the four subjects entrusted to me, right? The first one for miracles, second one to God to protect from, to have the protection from enemies. The third one for deliverance, and the fourth one, God to speak to his people. These four subjects, I pray in the name of Jesus, let everyone see a miracle in these subjects. Right now in the name of Jesus, I pray for this group. I pray for this 24-hour prayer group. I pray for Apostle Jacqueline, is her family, her ministry. Let the boundaries be enlarged. Let the number of members be increased in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, touch everyone in the name of Jesus. Let all the members have an increase in their anointing in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit is saying that those who believe, God is going to lift you into the next level. You are going to see the visions more clearly. Life is going to be smooth for you, Sister Samina Lloyd. When I saw your name, I saw powder. That means some talcum powder. It means life is going to be smooth for you. It is not be hard as before. It is going to be smooth for you. God is filling you with all his riches, taking away all the emptiness and filling you with his riches. Hallelujah. I hear the word paragon. I do not know the meaning of paragon. It is an English word. Sister Samina Lloyd, I have to refer the dictionary. Paragon, it is the paragon. I hear this word paragon in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Rasharama, in the name of Jesus. Lord, what that is broken be united in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, touch everyone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray for this prayer various, those who are ministering, those who are praying for everyone. Lord, touch everyone in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So may God bless you. God is going to increase the anointing of everyone. You are going to see miracle. You have been delivered. You have been delivered. How many of you say amen? You have been delivered. You are going to see the miracle. God is going to speak to you. You will never see any enemy in your life. These four subjects I prayed by faith. So how many of you believe that you will never see any enemy in your life?
God will speak to you from today onwards. And you will hear the voice of God. And you will be blessed in your life. Hallelujah. Your life, your ministry, everything will be successful. So may God be with you. I will pray for everyone. I pray for Apostle Jacqueline. I thank you for inviting me to minister in your group. May God bless everyone. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.